Ubiquitous Korean name.
Very common.
We're probably not related, but we're not trying to find out anyway, because we are both queer and partner with white partners, so cliches as well.
Yes.
So we can't all be
brutal.
Hey, make some noise if you're a fan of the podcast, Two Kids on Pod. Okay, the rest of you, wrong show. how you're here. And look, everyone we know in LA looks like they're here, right? Everyone we love and care about. Except for our family.
Really?
Mom, dad.
Pop that text.
Two pairs of parents not accounted for.
Yeah.
It's just the main reason we do this. We're doing this because we are
desperately seeking validation.
That's right.
Is anyone else here looking for validation?
Oh!
Oh my God!
Right in the front.
Yeah, your hand on
that.
Right away.
Up.
Yeah.
We practice with the tech. Like, we're gonna have to get the lights.
No, maybe raise up the lights. I know you raise me right away.
Just be shy, but not this one. Hi.
Hi.
No, you can't act shy now. I could be like.
Wait, immediately putting your hand up. Yeah. What was that?
What'd you say?
So your love language is words of affirmation?
Words of affirmation?
Okay, yeah.
God, that's a hard one for me.
You see our parents here.
Not one kind word.
Yeah. So we never learned, and so...
I don't know if we ever will.
But we're going to think about it. We're going to try.
You want to be told you're pretty?
Pretty? That's it?
What do you mean, that's it? Wait, why is that not enough? Is pretty not enough?
Hello, are you in Los Angeles?
I blow dried my hair for the first day and I was like, wow, she's a lady.
And before I can remove the words from my mouth, I told him that it looked good. And then later I was like, that was weird.
I know, we stood there for a second and I was like, can I go now? It was odd. But yeah, you want to be told you're pretty. We're actually very bad with words of affirmation. I've seen you with. By the way, I just want to thank Eunji for being here because she actually does live in Chicago. Oh my God, the angle! Can you see?
Okay.
This is like.
We're gonna be.
Okay, we did. It's trigonometry. Cosine, sine, tangent.
So you're looking for
anyway, you are digging a deeper hole. The less you want it, the more will. That sounds bad. I didn't want to finish that. We are on camera. We are. Live streaming.
No.
I hope we're not. Yeah. We need to edit this. But anyway, so yes, you are from Chicago, and I live here. We started this when we met in Chicago, and I'm so happy to have you here. And thank you to your family, your young children, one and seven, who are both, I think, sick. and you yes. left them to do this show.
Mommy's chasing a dream.
And it ends tonight. They'll have money back tonight, I guess.
Deferred. No. but yeah, I'm here from Chicago, so yeah, even my children have a tough time. You know what I mean? It's hard for me. They're 7, and I'm like, you could do better. So yes. It is brutal. It is hard.
We're gonna try. What's your name?
Sarah.
God, you're not ugly at all. So that's what makes this hard. You know what I mean? Like, if you were busted, we could lie to you. You know,
yes.
be like, you're so beautiful. Go off, girl. You know.
But like the affirming part of
it. The affirming.
Because is
like I see what you look like,
and then
I just don't want to.
Yeah,
give
like
it to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah.
And like here's no.
We don't want to lift you up too. You know what I mean? And that is our issue.
That's our
yeah.
issue. But we're gonna try for the rest of the show.
We're gonna put that in our minds, and we're gonna try during the rest
we're
of the show.
For the rest of the show. What's your name again? Sarah, she wants to be
pretty.
Pretty,
yeah.
She wants to be pretty. Sarah's pretty. Okay, we'll try.
Yeah,
right, let's meet some other people. We have some people right here. Green Beanie, peacocking. My eyes went straight to the line. Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Adele.
Adele? Is that? That's not Adele. Don't ever say I'm Adele to a gay man. I almost fell. No, Adele, sweet beanie.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Are you looking to be affirmed or validated in some way?
Don't start trouble. Don't start stuff you can't finish. Okay, what kind?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, okay.
You just want like general affirmations?
Yeah, yeah.
Are you a words gal or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, another Tucky.
Who's this next to you?
My boyfriend,
Tyler. What's up, Tyler? This is the most LA couple I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Shout out, Tyler. It's my pop princess Adele.
Wait, what are you saying? That? You're not
LA?
LA?
Where are y'all from?
Oh.
Jersey?
Okay.
What? You're too pale to be from Jersey.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wait, are you from?
Not like that Jersey.
Oh, not like Snookums? We're not talking about Snooky Jersey?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, stop talking to them, okay?
Thank you very much.
She said our safe word, so
yeah.
Promise.
Thank you very much. Hey!
We love
so
yeah.
happy
to have you here.
Yeah, thank you, Pasta.
Okay, how about that side? Stay right. Thank you, Pasta.
I
don't make it worse.
I missed that. Okay.
You know we're gonna have to edit that out.
I know.
Thank you, Pasta.
Yeah, but hey,
We have white partners.
I was pizza facing, I'm sorry.
Okay, can we meet this beautiful triplet right here? Aw, shit!
Yeah!
I'm sorry.
Are you guys from the other show? Did you guys see the other show? Oh, okay.
No. Why? Why did you ask that?
I thought they had come out from the other show.
You did? Okay,
yeah.
Wait, okay, so... Let me get a vibe. You seem very young, maybe like college-y. Are you like college friends?
Like Gen Z? Like
Are y'all Gen Z? Oh, you are.
Yeah. Are you there?
Are you their parents?
His parents? Yeah.
You started, yeah. Chaperones tonight.
Oh.
Okay. Are you underage?
No.
So you're not yet a woman?
You're 23?
Okay.
Not yet a woman. Oh,
still a girl, yeah. Okay.
Gotcha, sorry. Okay, what's your name?
Kayvon.
Okay, Kayvon, and you said you're 23. Why are you here? How did you hear about the show?
Yeah.
I just seen it and bought the ticket.
You just saw it? You just saw it and you bought the ticket?
Yeah. What did you see in us?
What was it that you saw and you said, Fuck yeah, yeah. That's my Saturday night. It's holiday season and fuck that. We're gonna see two loud queer Koreans scream. So yeah, what, let me guess. Are you a fan of Bobby Lee? This is why you booked us. This is why they told us you can do it without Bobby, and clearly we cannot.
Yeah. Are you guys all fans of?
All fans of Bobby.
Okay.
Bobby's back there right now. He can hear all of this.
Yeah. So you're all fobs. Okay. Cool.
Wait, what? Fobs? Followers of Bobby?
Fans of Bobby.
Oh, fans of Bobby. Because fob to Korean / Asian, some of us are triggered. Are you triggered by the word fob?
Yeah.
You are? Someone's triggered? Fob? Okay, what kind of fob are you?
Fresh off the boat.
No, I know. I said, what kind of fob? And she's like, let me just spell it out for her.
No, P. Yeah,
oh, wait, I'm sorry. Fresh off, were you spelling it out, or are you telling us you did that? Were you a guest star on the show? Because it's LA, so people would just be like, IMDb-ing out here. NCIS.
Was it traumatic? It was traumatic on set. Is that what you're saying?
She's not even listening to me. Okay. Let's move on. They're already drunk. Sorry, guys. You don't have to pound it. There's an intermission. Okay, so fucking relax. Jesus Christ.
Are you ready?
What for? What? Are we starting?
You want to play?
Oh. You want to play?
Who's
here to play? Yay! Who's here to play? Okay, vamp a little because I forgot that that. Hold on. Vamp a little for like 5 seconds, and also Connor, cut this out.
Wait. Okay. So, is anyone else triggered by Bob? Was anyone else like, wait, why are you pointing? Okay, you're Asian, and why is he triggered by Bob? What's faux?
Okay. Wait, hold on.
Wait, what's the faux?
Allow me.
Yeah.
I'm a faux liaison. Are you from the East Coast?
No.
I'm out.
Wait, you're saying it's pronounced faux?
Oh, like fresh off the boat.
Where did you grow up?
In LA.
And in LA, they were saying faux. What were they describing? That doesn't explain it. So in LA, where in LA are you from? Like, what is there a zip code that this is specific to? Okay. Are there any LA people that Angelinos that would
corroborate?
Corroborate?
No.
Wow. Where in LA are you from?
Monterey Park.
Let's start a turf war. Yeah. I heard pho. I asked East Coast because I'm from the East Coast, and my Korean friends used to use pho.
Pho?
Yes. And then after I went to college, I went fob. And now I'm afraid to say anything. Really am being silenced today.
Okay. That's wild.
Should we play?
Now let's play. Are you guys
All
ready
right.
to play?
You guys ready to play? We're going to play some games. All right, Nicole, go. All right, this first game is called Real Eyes, Real Eyes, Real Eyes.
I know.
Okay, this is a game. Let me explain it.
But I also have to say, I came home. And
home?
I came back to Peter's place,
yeah.
And Peter had made this graphic and named this game and turned around like this and started laughing uncontrollably as he said the joke. You've just read.
And?
You were really proud of yourself.
Okay, I don't think I understand the game yet. Let me set it up, okay? So what the first game we're gonna play is, really inspired by Korean Americans in Hollywood, Korean culture being just really proliferated everywhere in the media.
It's happening.
And we're here to celebrate that as two Kims. And this game, and by the way, you guys are playing this.
Yeah.
And we were originally going to give out like dollar bills for money, kind of like what we do in New Year's.
But we
like,
do not have any money.
Right?
Yeah. We do not have any money.
But, we don't want to. So, We're gonna go with compliments.
Yes.
Because you know that's hard for us. So we're gonna, if you win, you're gonna get a compliment. All right. So how this game works is you're gonna have to. We're gonna show you a pair of eyes, an actor from
just the eyes
from TV
just
and
the
film,
eyes.
A Korean actor from TV and film.
Just the eyes.
Just the eyes. Thus, you see, you know this game.
I think I already know where it's going.
Well, yeah. The, this joke says it all. Realize. 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 Hit it, Nadal. Okay, easy. Start easy. If you ever get the
first hand,
raise your hand. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. First, raise, first hand.
Was that? Yeah.
Go.
Sandra.
Go. Next. Wait, don't. Go next slide to confirm. Is this Sandra? Nadal, next. Yeah! Who said that? What's your
name? You,
you, okay.
You need,
can you? I'll take one. Yeah. Okay. But do you want to do that one because my mic won't reach?
Do you want to step into the light a little bit? Yeah. Okay. So you want to stand up or is okay?
What are you going? Are you going for like looks, aesthetics, vibe, aura?
You're.
Go do it, be real. Don't be all like trying to like sarcastically get out of it.
I know. You are dressed appropriately for the weather. and that means that you are smart.
Nice tap. Nice tap. Nice tap. Yes. All right. Shall we move on? Next person. Okay.
Okay, who is
who,
it?
Who gets? Who knows
who's
it?
Who's gonna ask? Raise your hand.
Raise your hand. Okay, back there.
Steven Yeun.
Whoa!
Let's see. Let's see. Yeah! Okay, that's my friend. That's my friend. So you do that one too.
Oh. Wait. Which friend?
He has a hat on. Yeah. Really drink it in first.
Okay. Oh, you're.
Be honest. Be vulnerable. Show them your eyes.
You.
Give it to him.
Don't say it like that. Your warmth.
No, stay there.
Oh yeah.
Do you see how bad she can
you
do it?
You appear like a generous and giving. Lover.
Oh! Wow.
That's actually something I say about myself. So,
because nobody else will. sorry to air that out.
Yeah, that's okay.
You know, let's keep going. Should we move on?
Yeah, let's move on.
Let's move on. That's done a little. Yeah. Sorry. I want to apologize in public, but. All right, next one. Okay, this one.
There's only one eye. Because this actor or actress is only half Korean.
Okay? And if you, wait, hold on. If you know, raise your hand. Don't shout it out. Half Korean.
Oh, yes.
Where?
Wait, yes.
Let's see. Yeah! 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 He might be half Korean, but he's 100% of Hong Kong.
You were zooming in on that May December viewing.
Charles Melton, wow.
Yeah.
Charles melts in my mouth.
Sorry, are you gonna give the compliment?
That's also my friend. Okay, I'll do it. I can't.
You can't watch me do it again.
Oh my God, I hate this. This is Kathy, by the way. Kathy. You, because I know you, I'm gonna go deeper than looks because you're already beautiful, but. Oh, see, this is why I don't do it. Fuck this. This is why I don't do it! Hold on, that's it. Okay. Kathy, you are.
You have to
are,
be vulnerable. Open yourself.
You are a incredible mother. Thank you. Let's move on. Keep it going, Nadal. Okay, this one. Oh, this one might be, The biggest star of all.
Yeah.
Anyone?
Any guesses?
Raise your hand. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Should we give them a clue?
Yeah.
You want a clue?
Okay.
Okay. He's really big.
He's huge. And a fashion icon.
A monochromatic icon.
Icon.
Anyone have a guess? What'd you say? Let's see who it is.
Iconic. That's our, yeah. Our dear leader.
Our dear leader of Navy. Our Navy God. All right, that was fun. Was that fun? Gratuitous. Thank you. All right, Nadal, we're gonna do a second game here, and this one, we've run out of compliments, obviously, so we are gonna pay the actual price today, so you better get ready.
Yeah.
Okay, so another thing that, this one's inspired by the proliferation of Korean food. And yes, Korean food is everywhere. Kristen Kish, for new presenter on Top Chef, anyone? Yes!
You can get a kimchi jar at Whole Foods, at your local whatever's, you know. I don't know your local grocery trains, but yeah.
Yeah, Erewhon.
Yeah.
Your college savings. So anyway, we're gonna go into, and how many people feel like they're foodies, self-proclaimed foodies? Oh, a couple. Okay. This is not gonna go well. All right. Hit it, Nadal. Name that dish. We're gonna give you the ingredients, and you're going to raise your hand if you know the name of this iconic Korean. These are three iconic Korean dishes. If you paid attention to YouTube cooking in the last 5 to 10 years, any Top Chef episode in the last 10 years. You would have seen one of these dishes. All right.
Yeah, so, already white cooking influencer. Also, they are doing this.
Oh yeah, Alison Roman's doing
it. Yes, everyone's doing it.
Is she uncanceled? Can we like her?
Yeah, we're back to life.
Her cookies are bomb. Yeah. Okay. All right, hit it. Ingredients: rice, spinach, fern break,
kosari,
carrots, mushrooms, or beef, gochujang. Raise your hand. Gochujang, fried egg.
Yeah.
Let's see it.
Yes!
She's so excited. All right.
I know.
We have
a gift for you instead of a compliment, because we can't muster up anymore.
This is really thematic to what we really love and enjoy together as hosts and friends is self-care and well-being. We love to be at a Korean spa. So do you want to open it and show people what it is? No, not that!
Oh.
This is what I got.
Alright, wait. You want that? Connor, cut it.
I mean, if you want that,
this is the magic of cinema.
Yeah. Reverse.
What's your name?
Julia,
yes. Trust me, you're gonna like that way better. Yeah. I put it in this silver thing to make sure. I'm like, don't do this one. And of course I did.
Can you tell us what's in the bag?
Julia, what's in it?
One bath bomb.
Yeah.
Wow.
And one sheet mask.
Yeah! Enjoy, Sylvia! All right, yeah, we love you. Oh wait, hold on, Sylvia, are you Korean?
I'm Julia.
What did I call her, okay. Sylvia?
No, she said she's Korean. You asked her if she's Korean, and she said, I'm Julia. The joke.
None of this is gonna work. Are you even filming? Just stop filming. Julia. Are you Korean, Julia?
Yeah.
No. You got a cheerleader. That feels like a little
cheat,
right?
Yeah.
Because she's Korean.
Yeah.
So next person can't be Korean. Okay. We can't have only Koreans with shit. Come on, stop it.
Yeah.
We can't, you know, stop. This isn't North Korea.
Right? Yes.
Ingredients: cube zucchini, cube white onions, cube potatoes, pork, belly or ground, chewy wheat noodles, black bean paste, sliced cucumber. Raise your hand if you know it. Are you Korean?
Me?
Yeah.
No, I'm not Korean.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Is it jajangmyeon?
Yes. Yeah! Yeah! It's right here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is it. Oh. Yes.
That's everyone! What's your name, winner?
I'm Amy.
What kind of Asian are you?
I'm Chinese.
We can't ask that?
Yes, we can. In this space, we can, yeah.
She is silencing me all night.
I am.
All right, congrats for the win. All right, one last one. This one's really hard, so the prize is big. Vulnerable moment. A personal slight.
A bruised ego. Emotional festering.
Han. Which is? Rage, rot,
from such a risk of oppression.
Okay, English is my second language. Okay? And then it's time, and then yeah, more Tim.
Tim.
Okay, we're talking about Tim the Tool Man Taylor. Does anyone know what this dish is? No!
Oh!
Wait, did someone guess it or did we just go to it?
Wait, I was like, before you went to push to the time and then it was, yeah, sorry.
All right, well, was anyone going to guess that, honestly?
No.
Good.
All right.
That's fine.
Okay. All right, next up. All right, so our last game before we, by the way, we do have Bobby Lee. Make some noise if you came here for Bobby Lee. It's okay, you can.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
Why are you not? Yeah.
You better whoop and holler right now.
You literally.
Don't be bringing out manners now.
Yeah, y'all of you are here.
Anyway, Bobby's here, and get excited. He's an icon. He's a ledge. All right, two Kim's One Pie. We're going to go our last game before we move on to the second act. We haven't forgotten about you, Sarah. We're trying.
Yeah. I'm really thinking. Yeah.
We're really thinking about it. Okay, we'll do a last game. This game really is set up for what? For them to know us a little better, and then for them to practice empathy.
Oh, is it? I didn't know.
Sorry. Yes. This is because, you know, it's something that I'm personally working on, and I thought maybe like if we can role play you having empathy for us. Then I could then, you know,
reflect that back
on you one day. So, all right, this game is called Would You Rather
Drama Edition.
So those of you who
are familiar with the pod,
yes,
you know that we have a segment of the podcast that is called Trauma Lava Ding Dong. And we kind of rehash trauma that we've experienced. And so we're going to be asking you which...
In a really funny way.
Yeah, it's not bad.
We've never cried. I won't let her.
Yeah. Also because we can't. Okay, yeah. So we're going to ask which one would you rather experience.
Okay, so you're like putting yourselves in our shoes. All right, so there's a theme for each round. And the first round's theme is... Childhood. Okay, so would you rather be... bullied for having puffy nipples,
or have your first memory be you peeing on yourself?
Now, before we're gonna get a round of applause to see who you'd rather experience, but before we do that, we'll open up for any like questions you might have just to get clarity for your decision because everyone must vote. It's your civic duty. So, does anyone need clarification, or is this like pretty clear? Yes. Why?
Yeah.
I had them out.
Okay.
It was childhood.
Didn't know. They were puffy. Yeah. I you know when you're like, you don't really know about yourselves until someone's like,
put it away.
They puffy. Yeah. You know, so they do puff, and especially, barometric pressure really. anyway, so any other questions before you vote? Seven to this morning.
Yeah.
All right.
They're really feeling bad for your puffy nips.
They should. Okay, anyone? Yeah.
Yeah, when you peed yourself, like a public location, was
was it more of a private moment?
Oh, no, it was in public in front of a kindergarten class, and it was it was in school and in front of many strangers, like new and never friends. So that's my first memory, asking a lady to pee. And then on myself. Any other questions?
Yeah, one last.
Well, it's a two-part question. So does anyone else remember that you peed on yourself?
I'm sure the teacher who I peed in front of, I don't know. It was also like first grade, you know what I mean? Like, it was just, I didn't know how to say the word bathroom in English. So I really had to go, I was fully potty trained. I wasn't a loser. So like, you know, I could do it, but I didn't know the word for it. And you know, you're in a new place. So, and that is my first memory. So yeah, I'm sure she might remember, you know, a gorgeous little girl peeing on herself.
Do they remember?
I'll never forget.
Yeah, I do still keep them out. Yeah. So, yes, they do. All right, we're going to vote for just round of applause. Round of applause if you'd be bullied for puffy nips. Round of applause for first memory peeing on yourself. Damn it. All right. She got this round. All right, round two. Let's go to Amma. That's right.
This is like trauma inflicted by our mother.
Yes, the person we used to live inside. All right. So, would you rather be encouraged to try girls again,
or recently,
10 months ago?
Or shamed for having a juicy push.
Push?
Puss. It's hard for me to say.
It was so juicy. Yeah. It was too juicy.
It's hard for me to say. Yeah.
It's triggering. Okay, so that's all you know. Okay, anyone, quick questions. We have one question each person.
Yeah.
Because we have to go.
Your mom, how does your mom know you have a juicy push?
Oh, this is great.
She was washing my underwear in a river.
As Korean mothers do in the old world. Beating a child, a gorgeous child's panties upon some river rocks.
And she saw the debris residue?
Yeah.
Remnants? I don't know, but you get it. You know what I'm saying? Crunchiness. And so, should I not go? Keep going?
No, they seem to love it. Okay. Anyway, one question for my thing. Yeah. Unless you don't need it. Okay, go.
Mine was more about the puss.
How do you work out with the puss? It's not that. The puss time's over. Any questions for my trauma? Thank you.
How did mom bring it up?
How did she? I picked her up at the airport and I complained about my white boyfriend because he is an artist and therefore not taking care of me. And then she responded with, "You could try girls again." So, all right, let's vote. Make some noise for try girls again. Make some noise for Juicy Puss.
Yeah, you'd rather be
2-0. This is not going as I thought.
Next slide, adults.
All right, final one. This sexy. Okay, would you rather be called the wrong slur mid thrust?
Also, by the way, this presumes there is a right slur.
We know there is.
Or being fingered by an unhoused gentleman.
We have time for one question for each.
Yeah.
Because we have been getting the flashing light, so yes. Bobby's getting tired. Yeah. All right. One question. Yeah, go.
Please tell me it was consensual.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's
implied. Yeah.
You wouldn't bring up, right? You were.
I told you. Yeah.
Wait. No. Yeah, you did. She was like, put parentheses, consensual. And I was like, they're going to get it that it was consensual.
Yeah.
But also, what do you think of her that she was not? I mean, I guess it could happen. Sorry. Why am I mansplaining that?
Yeah.
Back to your lane.
Another question? Yeah.
Okay, yeah, one question for my thing.
Yeah.
I'll give you a hint. I'll give you okay. Yeah, I will. Cuz I had told this person that I was Korean. But he did not call me Gook.
So yeah. Then if then blank.
Yeah. You want to take a guess?
No. You know what?
We're in a safe space. Are we safe here to do that?
Wait, are you really confused?
Yeah, I'm kidding. I love that this guy was like, yeah, let her do it. I need to live vicariously. Yeah, so it was one of the three. Anyway, yeah. Okay.
I didn't realize he was unhoused. I just thought he was like, hipster.
You can't keep giving stuff. I'll give justifications too.
Okay, what's your justification?
He looked like a white Ninja Turtle.
Oh my god!
Make some noise for Rock Slur.
Or being fingered by an unhoused gentleman. I knew you win this.
I win this one, right?
Yeah,
thank you for the win. I begged for it. All right, that was fun. Did you guys have fun? Do you feel like you can empathize with us now?
Yeah.
Okay, and Sarah?
We're gonna keep trying.
We're gonna try, okay. We're gonna keep thinking about it. So we're gonna take a quick, oh no.
Tops and bottoms.
Oh, do we have time? I don't think we have time to do tops and bottoms. You know what? Just play the sound thing because I made it. Go.
Rock hard tops and soft, flaccid bottoms.
Can you just say it? We don't have to go from there. I can do mine.
Okay, this is we're running really behind because you guys are laughing so much.
And we are damaged.
I'll
do mine and then you can do yours.
Do your top and bottom real quick and I'll do my top and bottom.
Okay, go. Okay, so do you see him? My rock hard top is I did a Hanukkah presentation for my son's first grade class and I killed. You guys can understand. It just felt really good because I did a Lunar New Year presentation last year and I bombed.
No, dude.
Okay. So my bottom is I forgot to bring a Secret Santa gift and I was gonna pay for my friend's dinner and I said I'll pay for this and then the group of four girls assumed I was paying for the table and I did it.
Oh no.
And the restaurant was so fancy.
Oh no, and you are poor.
Yes. It was bad.
That's the worst part of it. Yeah. Shut the fuck up. My god. So annoying. I don't even want to do mine. Yeah. I'm so annoyed. Okay. I'm looking forward to doing mine because whatever. Anyway, so my top this week was my birthday last week, so that was a top. Thank you. It was really great. We had a staycation, it was lovely. Okay. The bottom though, okay, so on the Monday before my my birthday, I was like, you know what, it's gonna be a staycation, I wanna get this will set it up first, so you'll be happy. So I wanted to get like nice and like bathed, so I went to a Korean spa. Yeah. And I was meeting my friend there, so I was like, why don't I go down, she was a woman, so like I was like, I'll go to the men's spa, do the hot tub, all that stuff, and I'll meet you upstairs. So how many of you have been to a Korean spa? Make some noise. Okay, so you all know, how big are the towels at Korean spas?
Tiny. Too small.
Like this, like hand towels, right?
Yeah.
Because we are...
They're barely enough to cover those nips.
I know, truly. So I washed up and I had one of those towels. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like, you're just around like other men, so you're just kind of like hiding your junk and walking by, right? You're not like trying to pull the whole thing
around. Is that men don't do both?
No, I wasn't hiding my butt.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know if other men do, but yeah. I was hiding my front.
Okay, full hole, okay.
Yeah, what? Full hole? No, I'm like walking like this.
Oh, you're clenched hole, okay.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing, why I was clenched, because I had made the mistake of eating a bean burrito, and I was a little gurgly, right?
Before so
I was
like, the spa?
Before the spa, and then, you know, you get in the hot tub and you cook. So I was feeling gurgly, and I was like, all right, you know, like, let me just go wash up, and then, you know how, like, have you ever, like, taken a shower and then, like, went to take a poop? You know how, like, I hate how wet it is on the seat, right? So I was like, let me dry completely
off. Wait, you shower, then poop?
Yeah, I didn't
try again,
shower.
No.
I know. I was being a white woman. I was fucking confused.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I went down there and I showered, and then I was like, I'm gonna poop, but before I poop, yeah, like I gotta dry off, yeah, right? So I'm like drying. I dry all the way off with this tiny towel. Okay. Imagine how long that takes, right? And then I'm like, okay, shimmying over, but I got a tube. Right?
Oh.
I know. And I'm like, all right, you can afford one tube. Oh. You know how like you do the math?
No, the rent is too high. The rent is too high.
No, the tube is affordable. It's Section 8 tube. So I'm like, I could afford one tiny tube, I'm gonna let it out. And I turn around to like, you know how like you spread the butt cheek to let it out so that you don't hear? So it's silent. So I go like this and I spread the butt cheek to let it out. And when I tell you, I catch myself in that huge mirror. And then the only thing I could describe it as is a cocoa nip falls out of my butt and onto the floor. And not only does that happen, I see it happen in the mirror. So I'm seeing it dispensing out of my butt. Like, have you ever been to a petting zoo? You know what I mean? Like when you see goats, it looked like a goat like pelling. Maybe you should have went first. And that was my bottom.
Oh my god.
Thank you so much. We're going to be right back. Take a 10-minute. We do your drinks. Tip the bartender. We'll be back with Bobby Lee. All right, bye. We'll be back.